Get ready to match the stars from Charlie's Angels, David Doyle, Rhett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Raymond Burr, and Joyce Bulafont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn.
Hey, how are you? How are they? Good group. Thank you for showing up. Nice to get in out of the cold, isn't it? I tell you, Ira, Scotch, our producer, had a wonderful idea. At the moment we are taping this show, it is 110 degrees here in Los Angeles. And, I mean, these poor people have been standing out there in line for 2 hours waiting to get in here. And he says, listen, why don't we get a whole 90 gallons of lemonade and give it? And then we tried, and we couldn't get a hold of it. Well, we tried for you, friends. Yeah. Well, let's applaud them for standing in the line in 110 degrees. Thank you very much. You're a wonderful bunch. Have you ever seen 300 dehydrated people? That's what they look like. Now, let's welcome our two players here, Betty Warfel and Linda Claridge. Applause, applause, applause. Betty's the current champ. She has $3,050 there. And she's been clutching a good luck symbol, and it's brought her good luck. She's won 3 games, and she's been challenged here by Linda Claridge. Linda's had her first round question, found out that it's not as easy as it looks when you're watching at home, right?
No, not at all.
Well, it gets easier as you go along here. If your ladies are ready, we'll do a little commercial, and then we'll come back and continue the game. Watch this, please. Here we go. This is the other round one question. Betty, this one's all yours. Everyone will participate in this, please. Mrs. Jolly Green Giant said it's strange being married to Jolly. Every night before he goes to sleep, he kisses his blank.
We were talking. I'm sorry.
You what?
We were talking about patty.
You were talking?
Yes.
And you didn't hear a word I said?
No. Could you just do it again?
No, I'm sorry. Write an answer. Your job is to listen to what I am...
It wasn't only me, it was...
Your job is to listen. You didn't hear it either.
You were listening.
We were.
But we were listening to a
lot. Oh, I see. Last chance.
Jane.
This is Jolly Green Giant said.
Just a minute.
I'm ready.
Oh, you're ready, Jeff. The one time Charles has finished first, and here you are. You haven't even heard the question yet. Mrs. Jolly Green Giant said it's strange being married to Jolly. Every night before he goes to sleep, he kisses his blank. Okay. Mrs. Jolly Green Giant said it's strange being married to Jolly. Every night before he goes to sleep, he kisses his...
ceiling.
His ceiling? Don't give up, Linda.
That was a good one.
She's won 3 games, but I think he got a chance. He kisses his ceiling. Would you like to explain that?
Well, he's way up in the air there.
Oh, he's tall. I see. Okay.
I understood it.
He's tall.
Very, very good answer.
Yes. What do you say?
Ho, ho, ho. I thought possibly he would kiss his niblets.
His niblets, yeah.
That's one of the products, corn niblets.
Well, everything I wrote down. Like I said, melons and peas and oranges, and Charles kept saying, he doesn't raise oranges, he doesn't raise melons, he doesn't raise it. Finally, I said, carrot.
Okay.
And he said, he doesn't raise carrots.
No, they're famous for all of their vegetables, aren't they? What do you say?
Yes, they certainly are.
All right, Smarty, you're on. You know everything?
Your Raphael suit that doesn't fit. Because you're too...
It's amazing what the heat can do to a middle-aged woman, isn't it? Niblets.
Roger.
Hello.
Hello. I said niblets also.
Okay. You spelt ceiling correctly, Roger. I was just having a little colloquy with a member of the staff here who traditionally is a rotten speller, and here's one of the hardest words of the English language, and he spelled it correctly. Isn't that fascinating? No? Show us your answer.
I want to see if I spelled it correctly.
Peas.
Peas, okay. Another vegetable. Name a vegetable there, Joyce.
A niblet.
Niblet. Okay, that's one. They're famous. You know, niblets. You've heard of them. Okay. Now we go to round two. Linda Claridge, A or B?
I'll try A this time.
A. You had B last time?
Yeah.
Didn't do too well with that one, did you? Let's see how you do with it. Phil said, I went to the world's worst restaurant. I got indigestion just looking at the blank. World's worst restaurant. I got indigestion just looking at the blank. Put it in the slot there. Phil said, I went to the world's worst restaurant. I got indigestion just looking at the blank.
Menu.
At the menu, of course. Ah, yeah. That is the definitive answer.
It certainly is.
Oh, it is indeed. Show us your definitive answer.
You're just carried away on a wave of you-know-what. Menu!
Oh!
Because I'm wearing a Raphael suit and I was born in the French Quarter of Hartford, Connecticut. La carte, which means menu.
La carte, of course you did that. Thank you very much. La carte, he said, or menu, as they say in his country.
I said menu also.
Oh, you said that also. What do you say? No?
Before you get the menu.
Yes.
You get the waitress.
Oh, I see. All right. Are you aware of the fact that you are booing a living legend? Okay, Joyce, show us yours.
I know that restaurant, and he's right.
Oh, really?
menu.
Oh, there it is. Five for Linda. You'll have a chance to go to work after this message for America. Here we go. Now, Betty, you need five to tie, six to win. Sid said, when I first met my wife, I was hooked. That's because she was blanking at the time. When I first met my wife, I was hooked. That's because she was blanking at the time. You have, I don't know whether Johnny Olson told you or not, but this sweet lady has 15 children. And there are three living at home now. But she did it the hard way, one at a time. No twins or triplets or what.
Jane, yes. Also explain why her husband hasn't been able to come because he's too exhausted.
That's right. He's back home. He didn't make the trip out here. Betty, Sid said, when I first met my wife, I was hooked. That's because she was blanking at the time.
Hooking?
Hooking.
Shame.
Okay, David.
Well, I tell you, we're on the right wavelength. I said she was a hooker at the time.
Okay. That's what they do, isn't it? Hookers do hook, don't they? Who told you about that, Betty?
I was thinking of hooking a rug.
Oh. She said, I was thinking of hooking a rug, yes. What did you say?
Well, Johnny, I said she was fishing.
Uh-huh. Hooking, yes, of course. Charles? Got to match everybody else?
Fishing,
so that means Linda Claridge wins the game. What the rest of you have down here? Fishing, hooking. Betty Warfel, it was a pleasure to be with you. You've got $3,050 and our best wishes. There she goes.
Thank you. Yeah.
Betty Warfel, goodbye. Now, here it is, all for you, the big Supermatch board and the big Star Wheel board, Linda. And this is the way it goes. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, a very smart bunch like these. And we said, write down your best answer to this, the seven blank. The seven blank. $500 for matching the most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Three of our six ding-a-lings will give you some assistance here. Call them one at a time.
Brett, please.
The seven dwarfs.
There's one.
Charles.
One of the things Brett is, the seven deadly sins.
Ding-a-ling. Wonderful.
The third is a tough high position. Five. Maybe something will come to you.
How about
The 7 o'clock news.
The 7 o'clock news. That was an inspired idea. So you have the 7 o'clock news, the seven deadly sins, and the seven dwarfs. Now you can choose one of those or give us one of your own. What is your pleasure?
The seven dwarfs.
Okay, that's what you want. Let's find out if they're up there. And if so, where? May we see the $100 number? The seven wonders of the world. We're looking for seven dwarfs. May we see the $250 number?
Seven C's. I don't believe that.
We don't have anything that the celebrity said so far.
It's
well, let's all keep
there.
Our fingers crossed for Linda. Here we go with the big one.
Yeah, very good. Congratulations.
Well, really. Holy, who said it? Oh, keep on winning. Okay, Linda, you picked up another $500 here. That means the least you can be playing for. What's going on here?
I'm looking at the wheel. Oh,
the least you play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But if you get a good lucky spin of the star wheel, you double your money. Come on up here and give it a spin, Linda, and good luck to you. Let's see if it stops in the area that will double your money. Oh, you just missed it. But you will be playing with a good player, Charles Nelson Reilly, and you will be playing for $5,000. Good luck to you. Here it is. Ready, Chuck?
Yo!
All right. You face me if you would, please, and this is it. Princess Blank. Princess Blank. She's got her answer all set. Okay, Chuck is ready. Now, Linda, give us the answer that he's written on the card. If you do that, we give you $5,000.
I said Princess Grace.
Princess Grace. All right, Charles.
Well, last night, English, I went to a party for Anthony Newley's mother, remember?
Yes. Yeah.
And what is her first name?
Rose.
Grace.
Who's out there rooting for you?
My mother, Gail, and that's Christy, and that's my boyfriend, Brett.
Well, we're very happy for you. $5,600. All right, we'll bring out another pair now. Here comes step five, Greg Ridgway. Let's welcome him. Roger. Take that back with you. Go right around there if you would, please. She's very happy. Hi, Greg, how are you?
Hello.
This girl is very happy and very excited because she won a big bundle of money. Now, Spec 5, Greg Ridgway.
That's right.
Let's see. Boy, you got all kinds of stuff hanging on your chest there. Well, let's find out a little bit about you. And you got a hash mark there? What does that mean?
This hash mark is for every 3 years that you've been in the service.
Right.
I've been in the Army 4 years last month.
Right. Yeah. And what do you do? What are your specialties?
Well, I am Greg Ridgway. I'm 22 years old and single. I'm presently stationed in Indianapolis, Indiana, home of the Army Dollar. It's a big finance base, and I live only 40 miles north of there, so it's pretty convenient.
That's good. Yeah. Well, nice to have you here with us.
Thank you.
We're going to stop and do a little business with America before we begin this game. Both of you stand by and just have a deep breath here. Watch this. Senator Johnny O, we're ready to go here now. Okay, if you're both ready, we'll push a button, reveal round one. And Greg, you're going to have A or B.
I'd like B, please.
B it is. Spec 5, Greg Ridgway. Jim said, it's strange being married to a cheerleader. Every time we get romantic, she yells, blank! Do not gesticulate.
I didn't gesticulate.
Okay.
Did I just gesticulate?
You were gesticulating. It might suggest an answer to someone and mislead someone.
We gesticulate. Is that very true?
Okay. How are we doing here? Brett's just about ready, Greg. Here it is. Jim said, it's strange being married to a cheerleader. Every time we get romantic, she yells, blank!
Yay.
Yay.
Yay, yay, yay.
It's an affirmative right. yell, right?
Wouldn't you be affirmative?
Yes. Kiss me. Yay! Hello there.
I was in a hotel once next to a cheerleader on the road, of course, but I heard I heard this all through the night. Hold that line!
That what you heard?
That's what I heard.
But only through the wall.
Through the wall. Through the wall.
You yourself, of course, were not involved in any way, shape, or form.
Naturally.
You lie. God's going to turn you to stone for that.
Yeah. Get ready for this.
The voice of doom.
Mr. Raphael with his J.C. Penney jacket. 1, 2, 3, 4, who are we going to cheer for? Is that a yay?
Apparently.
That doesn't sound like a yay.
Apparently not.
Doesn't anyone see my little chin trembling?
It's all right. You tried.
All of them.
You turn on
score.
Me.
Score! Score!
Interesting. Every time we get romantic, she yells, score! Hello, Elaine.
Hi.
How are you?
Okay.
Good. You want to talk about something?
Sure.
What?
She was positive. She says, rah!
Rah! That's a yay. Rah is a yay.
Half-time.
Half-time. Every time she yells, half-time, it's... Is that like timeout? Okay, Joyce.
She starts going, lean to the left, lean to the right, stand up, sit down, fight, fight, fight.
You were a pom-pom
no,
girl.
I was wrong, I was. Yes. Touchdown.
We shall not pursue the subject any further, but we will get a response from Linda on this question. Her first rounder, Nick said, now I know how El Cheapo Airline keeps it costs so low. During the flight, everyone had to take turns blanking. That's how they keep their costs so low in El Cheapo Airlines. Everyone has to take turns blanking. What? Write it down. Let me see. Terrific. All right. El Cheapo Airlines. Everyone had to take turns.
Charles has one card in. He only has 8 more to go.
Okay. Joyce, did you put one in the slot there?
No, I'm sorry.
Okay. Nick said, now I know how El Cheapo Airlines keeps its costs so low. During the flight, everyone had to take turns blanking.
Flying.
Flying. You really didn't understand the question, did you, Linda? Did you understand it, David?
Well, I think we did. I think this is in accord with hers in that it's an attempt to do the very same that she said, which is flapping their arms.
Flapping their arms. Now, flapping the arms is not a match.
No, I don't want an argument.
Well, no, flying when you're flying.
Shush. Keep in mind that I'm probably in menopause.
Probably.
Probably. You passed that long ago.
This may be a match. This may be a match. I understood the question perfectly. Linda and I were the only two people here who obviously understood piloting the plane.
Well, now that is flying.
That is a true thing.
But flapping your arms is not flying.
Sometimes it is, baby. Don't know if you're trying.
Oh, dear. May the we last... have a quart of estrogens, please? Hello, Charles.
The last hot flash she got is when Truman won over Dewey. Flapping their arms.
Flapping their arms.
See?
Flapping their arms is a good response, I think. Elaine, what do you say?
I said leaning forward.
Leaning forward, yeah, that was anything dumb like that would be good. Raymond, show us yours.
It was a jet blowing.
Oh, yes, of course. to keep the, yes, to get the propellers to go around. Okay, Joyce.
He's learning how to play the game.
Yes, indeed he is.
I said flapping their arms.
Yes. Of course you said that, flapping their arms. Now, there we are at the end of round one. Score's tied 1-1. Round two coming up after this. Pay attention now. Gene Rayburner, join us next time, Match Game 78. Goodbye. Wasn't this hilarious?
Did you have fun? Say yes. Oh, God.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Chapman production. This program was edited for broadcast.